McRae, and I'm the co-founder and CEO of Meta Construction Technologies. Our product is called Blacktop, and it's a software as a service virtual fleet management system. It helps asphalt contractors get more jobs, run them more efficiently and profitably, and more safely. We do this by giving them control and visibility over their subcontracted fleet of dump trucks. You see, asphalt contractors don't always own enough dump trucks to get their job done. In fact, we're from Louisville, Kentucky, and our customer Hall Contracting, they don't have any dump trucks. So every day, if they need 15 trucks, for instance, they're gonna have to call up to 3 different sub-hauling companies or third-party trucking companies. Now, once those trucks are inbound, they have no visibility over it. And as we just heard, it costs them $1,000 an hour if they go idle. So it's critical that those trucks are right there when they need them. To compensate, they order too many trucks on purpose and spend the money just to have them there because it's more costly to not. So we're helping them by starting with a communication tool. We let them put in the details of the request into our platform, and then we turn around and communicate that out to the sub-hauling companies. Once they receive that request, they assign their drivers to that route. The drivers have our free mobile app on their smartphone, which means now they get to see the exact information that they need to about the job that they're driving. They also get to see turn-by-turn directions of where they need to go on the job site. That may not sound like a big deal, but this is heavy highway construction. They're not going to 123 Main Street. They're going to I-64 East, mile marker 46, gate C, and every time they go to the wrong entrance, that's just another delay that costs more money. The biggest benefit here, though, is that the foreman on the job site gets to see 15 trucks on a map. Now, this is a virtual fleet owned and operated by 3 different companies, but they can see all 15 of them as if it's their own fleet. And it's virtual because when the driver hits the stop button, they just fall right off of the map. So current GPS systems use physical hardware, and it's expensive. Hall Contracting it's not even their choice to purchase hardware and put on somebody else's truck. Let's just assume that all 3 of those sub-hauling companies actually have their own traditional GPS system. It's designed to be a closed loop, so each one of the dispatchers knows where those trucks are, but the asphalt contractor is still in the dark. And sure, they could pick up the phone and call, but if they're not just bored on the job site, curious where these trucks are at, if they have to be on the phone looking for them, it means it's too late and they're already losing money. So we're replacing that hardware with a mobile app. It gets everybody on the same platform in a very cost-effective way. It also lets us all funnel that data to the people that need to see it. So the asphalt contractor can see 15 trucks and each sub-hauler can see only the ones that belong to them. Now that we're collecting this data, we've got some really cool opportunities to have some downstream benefits for the back office work and some of the admin pieces. Instead of collecting the tickets and trying to interpret handwritten timesheets to then do billing and invoicing, we're already collecting timestamps of when they started and stopped tracking, as well as where they're at. We're also doing some data analytics and some cycle time analysis, so we can basically tell how long it takes to get to and from a job site to a plant or a quarry. This is really important because the idle time and travel time can help us provide the suggestion of what's the optimal number of trucks that they really need versus the number that they're actually using, helping them save money and be more effective on the job site. Now, we're starting in the asphalt contracting space because we have management experience and expertise there, but we really can help any business that lacks visibility over their mobile workforce. That's trade contractors, municipal utilities, light construction, and many others. Right now, we're starting with 50 cents an hour, which is really common for the construction industry. It allows them to take the cost of our software and pass it right along to the customer through their bids. But as we get into some different customer segments, we'll look at getting more of a monthly subscription model, which is common in software as a service companies. It'll help us get more predictable and smooth, predictable revenue and smooth out our cash flows. This year, we're looking to have 44 customers on our platform and be generating just under $200,000 in revenue from our Blacktop product. We'll do this with our current inbound marketing process where we're doing Google AdWords and some search engine optimization and social media marketing. But a lot of our time is really spent on outbound prospecting. We want to target and find our best qualified customers and make sure that we're really spending the time building relationships with them and educating them on the problem and our solution to it. We also have Ken Rush. He just recently joined our advisory board, and he represents somebody who's going to be crucial to us as we start to expand. He is a recently retired business development manager and knows a lot of the differences in each region. So as we start to scale and move into each region, somebody like Ken will be able to help us as we incentivize them and they can make relationships for us. So we have 3 customers and we're increasing our demos and free trial signups currently. We've raised over $400,000 now and have a finished product with a baseline functionality, and we're building on it as we get customer feedback. We started in the U of L Entrepreneurship MBA program, and we're a 2017 Vote Award recipient, as well as a 2018 Awesome Inc. company. So So we're based in Kentucky and Kentucky proud. I really appreciate you guys' time and your consideration in us winning the pitch today. Thank you.
Trucks already under management. Some of the companies were huge, like Verizon. So how would you differentiate yourself? And then the third red flag for me is people kept calling it the Uber of trucking. And whenever something is the Uber of anything, that makes me nervous.
Yeah, that's a great question. There are a lot of fleet management systems. In fact, I think Captera, we can find 300 plus that are ranked there. The biggest differentiator is that they're going to be using hardware to track those trucks. So it's expensive, and you basically need to make a capital investment in your own fleet. This is a mobile device that's free to the subhaulers, so they don't have any investment that way. That's our biggest differentiator. Could you remind me of your third question? I'm so sorry.
I mean, that was really the nature of the nature of it is how do you differentiate yourself?
Yeah.
Due to so many huge players that already are entrenched in a big way.
Yeah. So the customer segment that we're targeting is asphalt contractors, and they are not part of the customer base of the ones that you'll find there. So the real competition for us is people who are using Bluetooth low energy beacons to set waypoints between job sites and plants. But even those don't solve the problem of visibility in between transit. So we're really right on that edge where if people are coming up, there's kind of ancillary markets that they're serving, but not really in the heavy highway space.
I wanted to ask you, you are about a third of the way through this year, and it doesn't look to me like you're on track to get the number of customers that you say you're going to get. So could you talk about that?
Absolutely. Yeah, this is the beginning of the construction season, so on the calendar year, we are a third of the way, but they're just getting enough warm weather days where they can start paving. So we are still on track as far as we can tell. You know, it's still early, but we are billing customers and are in our net 30 terms to start receiving revenue already. And we have a potential customer that is the size of all of our customers that we were looking for the whole year. They operate 23 limestone quarries and 18 asphalt plants. And if we were to land that one customer, that actually would cover our financial projections for the year. So we're hopeful for that, but we're still filling our sales pipeline and hopeful for more customers.
And that point touched on my question, which is your addressable market. And so obviously this could be a universal global solution, but in Kentucky, where we are, talk about your addressable market. Who are your potential clients? Profiles, just more details than that.
Sure. Somebody around here would be like ATS Construction or Hinkle Contracting, and they're basically the one who has the pain and would pay for a solution like that. The other side of the kind of two-sided marketplace is going to be Haynes Trucking or some other third-party trucking companies that are in the area. So they'll end up using the system at no cost, and ATS or Hinkle would pay 50 cents per hour to use the system.
And your feedback from those companies is what at this point?
It's strong. Every time we do any customer discovery interviews, which we've done over 400, it's always that eyes light up kind of key that you're looking for. It's definitely a problem they face in the industry, and they're excited about a solution. Maybe received with a little bit of skepticism because they've seen other attempts at similar solutions, but our feedback has been very positive with early customers.
50 cents an hour resonates with them?
Yes, sir. Yeah, absolutely.
Good job.
Thank you very much.